Regina Daniel does not like her child to be dark skinned. She said that when she unveiled her baby with her husband, Ned Nwoko. Hi guys, you're watching Chiki Series. If you're a returning subscriber, thank you for your support. I appreciate that. If you're new to this channel, thank you for clicking on this video. Just sit back, let's get right into this video. So before I continue with this video, I want to put up a disclaimer. Actually, this video is not about Regina Daniel, Ned Nwoko and their baby. If you want to see the face of their baby, you head over to their channel on YouTube where they did an unveiling of their baby. So the reason why I'm making this video is because when the husband took the baby out in the morning to receive some dose of vitamin D from sunshine, she was trying to tell the husband to cover the baby so that the baby will not be dark, that she doesn't like her baby to be dark skinned. You may want to listen to her voice because due to copyright issues, I wouldn't want to play her videos on my channel, and you can as well head over to her channel and watch the full video there.
Boy, I don't want him to be dark.
Is there something wrong with him being dark?
Eh? Many yeah. Things though.
Are you serious? But that's the only claim you have for him then. The only claim you have that he's
my
like
color, at least. Yeah. Let me take that one.
So the annoying thing is that she's not the only one that think like this in Nigeria, because even WHO conducted a study which shows that more than 70% of women in Nigeria at some point we like to change the color of their skin to be lighter in color, maybe 2 shades lighter or 3 shades lighter, through the use of bleaching cream or through the use of skin lightening agents or even glutathione through injections. But the funny thing is that a black man is a black man. If you like bleach yourself from head to toe, you are still a black person. Your gene says so. I'm not the one who says so. But I want to make it clear, I'm not here to tell you what to use on your body, whether to use bleaching cream or not. You got your money, you know what to do with your money. Remember to think about the side effect and also have at the back of your mind that however you bleach your skin doesn't make you to be a white person. Regina Askia's daughter also threw more light on that because she has experienced Nigeria and also America. For people who don't know who Regina Askia is, she used to be one of the Nollywood actresses back in the days. They were the ones that really started the Nollywood industry. They were the foundation members of the industry. So she has a daughter with a French man, a white man, and her name is Na Edara, whose picture is on your screen right now. She recently talked about race on her channel. The topic is a mixed race rant, and her YouTube channel is called Edara. And she also came up with this, saying that when she was in Nigeria, people were addressing her as half caste, and she thought probably that half caste was something good because people were admiring her color, telling her that they would want to marry a white person so that they would give birth to white children. But she never understood that kind of mentality. But eventually when she went to the US, she was never even classified as a biracial because she has some part of her that is white. They simply call her black. So she was wondering why they were calling her a black person when in the real sense of fit, she is biracial. So what am I saying in essence? If you like bleach your skin from here to the moon and come back, you're not a white person, you're a black person. It is very funny that even when you're biracial, they still call you a black person, just like the past president of America, Obama. They call him black person, but in the real sense of it, he's a biracial. So I'll let you guys listen to her. If you want to watch the whole video, you can as well go to her channel and see the video there. For now, I only have the audio.
Seeing myself as a half-caste, basically seeing myself as a mixed person, I was constantly told that because I was mixed race, I was beautiful, that I was lucky to be mixed race by Nigerians mostly. And Nigerians would tell me, oh, I want to have mixed race babies just like you. And honestly, I still hear that shit today, and that shit pisses me off. But now that I think about it, it says a lot about the mentality in Nigeria, at least then. You put more value in a child that has white in them.
Yeah, I quite agree that the mentality is very sickening and disgusting, to say the least. I don't know where this standard of beauty is coming from. Nigerians need to define their own standard of beauty. That someone is dark skinned doesn't make the person less beautiful, not beautiful or ugly when compared to their counterparts with light skin. It is only a skin color. I think the mentality is whack. That's what people are meant to believe. But I don't have a problem with you preferring light skin or whichever color you want. But the issue is this, don't try to bring down somebody that has black skin or that has a dark skin, saying that you are finer than the person. Because that's where it starts. Some people, when they have children, they call them blacky. And some people call them darky. And they keep saying that a child is not beautiful because the child has a dark skin tone. Who told you that? A child is always a child. Parents need to build self-confidence in their children, even self-love. Because when you start criticizing your child, discriminating against your child, you've already brought colorism in your house. And when the child grows up, wants to tamper with the complexion, the same you will start asking the child, why is it that you want to rub bleaching cream? Why do you want to bleach? But you've been attacking the child, saying that the child's color is not good. And this bleaching topic has been a very hot topic ever since I know. I think late last year, towards the Christmas time, one lady that owns a spa in Lagos immersed herself in a chemical and said it was for whitening. So which made this TVC program Your View to talk about it. And this lady on the screen talked about when she had her baby, people around her, I think the nurses, were saying, oh, the baby's ears are dark, which means the baby will be dark. So I would like you people to listen to that.
So when I had my daughter, when she was born, she was very much, she was light skinned, but her ears were dark.
Dark.
So you'd know that she would eventually become dark. I know babies, you always wear the cap. I remember taking her for one of the appointments, doctor's appointments, and some of the, maybe they were interns or just young nurses who didn't have head. So they were like, oh, she's so beautiful, she's so gorgeous. So they had to take off her hat, her cap. And when they were like, oh, she's going to be black, oh. They looked so disappointed. In my mind, I'm like, your child or my child.
This kind of comment is very common in Nigerian society. And I'm just imagining somebody put to bed and you just give the person this kind of comment. That will even make the person to start thinking of how to bleach the skin of the baby, which some people do these days. They use bleaching cream on their baby. And this is very awkward, weird and sick to say the least. When you start a baby on bleaching cream, I don't know the kind of life you're creating for the baby. Probably you think you're doing the baby good. I don't think you're doing the baby any good, because from very young age, you start using bleaching cream. Before the baby gets to age 9 or 10, the effect of the bleaching cream will be on the baby's body. And it's not that the baby chose this path, it is the mother that put the baby in this kind of trouble. So this is the worst of self-hate. Even Wari Pikin talked about it during her interview with Tonto Tige in the program of Grub and Rub that Tonto Tige does on her YouTube channel. She said that there was a time she would go for auditioning and they would tell her that she's too black. Who does that? Nigeria is the most populous black nation in the world. And when you go for an interview, I can't understand. They are looking for a light-skinned person in a black country. So who do you want to find there? Or that the company is indirectly looking for a white person or a half-caste, as we call it, which simply means biracial children, to employ instead of employing black Nigerians. This is very weird. And again, this is what they call colorism. If there could be colorism in a black nation, I wonder what Americans would do. Because most things, these things are common in America, where they have preference to choose over white or black. But to happen in Nigerian society, this is very shameful and disgusting, because they are discriminating against their own race based on their skin color, which is like racism. And these same people complain about racism when they travel to Western countries. Just imagine the hypocrisy when they are busy tearing their own black race apart, which is highly unacceptable. Some people are so brainwashed that they don't believe in anything called Nigeria, don't believe in anything that is black. I don't know why they behave like that. So listen to Wari Pikin as she shared her ordeal.
So they go audition too, but they don't agree to take us because they say we're too black. I remember audition when I go, when I use night bus from Benin, go Lagos. They not take me, they say my color, they not just like my color. My color dirty, I don't know.
I will not come here and lie to you to say that I don't know that this kind of thing exists. I know that there are some type of jobs that they prefer to employ light-skinned people, like receptionist, marketing in the bank, and stuff like that. But for a company to say it to her face, telling her that she's too black and that her color is dirty, who does that? The company is not supposed to be operating in Nigeria, honestly. I don't know why some companies in Nigeria behave like that. And I've had somebody on this platform also express her ordeals when she went for an interview. Please don't allow anybody to cajole you into bleaching your skin, because black is very beautiful. Black comes in different shades. So for somebody to say you need light skin, you can't be saying that in Nigeria. At least Nigeria is the most populous black nation in the world. So black people should learn how to love their skin color the way it is, how God created them. Stop discriminating against people because of their skin color. Stop projecting your insecurities on people. If you want to bleach your skin, that's okay if that's what you want to do. But don't disrespect other people saying that their skin color is not good or that their skin color is dirty. Nigerians should create their own standard of beauty and not following the Eurocentric standard of beauty. Because as far as I'm concerned, this colorism came as a result of slavery. Because if you don't see any white person to compare your skin color with, how do you know that there are other skin colors? You learn to appreciate yourself, and that's it. I know there are some people that suffer from body dysmorphic disorder or body dysmorphia, which is a mental condition where a person spends a lot of time worrying about flaws in their appearance. And the funny thing is that these flaws are often unnoticeable to others. So don't allow people like this to get you confused about who you are. Your color is very beautiful. And there are some people that prefer to marry a white person so that they can have a biracial child. Anyway, I'm not here to tell you who to marry. Just make sure that whoever you're marrying the person out of love and not because you want a biracial child, which portrays very sick mentality. Let me know what you guys think about this. Black people practicing colorism, believing that their own dark skin tone is not good enough, valuing light skin tone over black skin tone. So guys, that's me done. I'm gonna sign off here. Stay healthy and safe. Remember to share this video with family and friends if you love it, and subscribe to my channel if you've not done already. I'm gonna catch you in my next video. Bye.